What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of Feed the Beast Infinity Evolved Expert Mode. Oh yeah, guys. So currently behind me in our alloy smelter, I got a lot of stuff going in here. We got a lot of iron, a lot of silicon, and a lot of coal dust that I've pulverized using our macerator over here from Industrial Craft 2. That thing's really fast and I like it for certain things like this. We are cooking up a whole lot of electrical steel. Yeah, the plan is that I'm going to be slowly building up our big reactor. And I started expanding it out just a little bit. So yeah, our big reactor, well, our small big reactor is this big. But eventually our big reactor might be this big. This is what I'm kind of thinking. I do believe this was a 23 by 23 by 10, I think. Question mark? I can't remember. I did make, what is that thing called? We should go figure out the exact dimensions for those of you who care about this kind of stuff. There's an item from Bibliocraft called a tape measure, and I have used this many times before in a lot of playthroughs. Tape. Yeah, this thing right here. Tape measure, Bibliocraft. This is a really neat item. You can place it, like, right here, and then say you move 3 blocks over, 4 blocks over, whatever. It'll tell you exactly how far away that is. So that's a really nice item, so you can tell distances and make perfect squares or rectangles or whatever it is that you are trying to measure out. So from right here to right here, that is 25. Okay, so it's 25 by 25 by 10. That's right. So that's what we got. That's the plan. I was figuring out how many blocks we needed, and it was something like 2,300. It's a lot. Over 2,000 blocks. To get all the walls in and the top and the bottom, not to mention all the stuff that's going to go inside, but that's going to be far off. That's a lot of stuff that we are going to need. So I was just kind of framing it out, figuring out how many blocks we needed and starting to get all of the reactor frame blocks ready to go. So yeah, it costs a lot of electrical steel to make those blocks, and that's why I'm cooking that stuff up. I did go through and I smelted all of our yellorium here. We have 30,600. You can see that on the tooltip. That's a heck of a lot of yellorium. So yeah, all of our ore I did smelt down. Well, I put it through the sag mill, so we got the additional amount that I smelted that all. But yeah, that's what we ended up with. So that's a crazy amount. So really good. Good stuff. I like it. Okay. So what are we going to do today? What are we going to do? I think we should go take a look at our bees real quick. Like I said, I put in the bees that we found in these hives over here, and I haven't done any breeding at all. All I did, we went around to those villages, right? And I did find a forestry village building, I think maybe one or two, something like that. And they had bees already inside of them. And those are some of the bees that I used here. I just put them in the hives and I walked away. I didn't do anything with these things. So we got meadows growing here. Whoops, another meadows here. Let's see what we got. Forest. This one is ignoble, by the way. See, this one says pristine. This one says ignoble. So the ignoble are bees that are supposed to degrade over time and the princess will eventually die off. So it's not a very good one. However, that's been going for a while now and I don't think that option is turned on in this mod pack. So I don't think the ignoble matter. So this is a noble bee right here. And if we look over at the board, we can see that in order to get a noble bee, we needed to do the common and the cultivated. Well, I never did any of that stuff. Like I said, all I did was put those hive bees in here. So I guess this bee right here was already crossbred with another one and just doing its thing. Yeah, it turned into that on its very own. So we have a common bee here. That was one of his children and some forest and then noble. So yeah, I didn't have to do anything. So that's really awesome. We got valiant bees over here. I don't think this was a valiant when I started. I think that was another regular hive bee. Actually, we can look inside here. Yeah, we have meadows in here. So that must have been another one that we found that was like half meadows, half valiant. And then the valiant just took over. And then we have more forest and more meadows. Cool. So as the bees do their thing, you can see the little particles flying around. They spawn all these different flowers, which is kind of cool. Things I've noticed, it spawns every kind of flower in the game, including the ones that you find in the nether called the eye bulbs. And those don't like being either in the direct sunlight or on grass, one of the two, and they find them popped off. So if you walk around here with a magnet on, you'll get stuff in your inventory. Another thing it is spawning are these death bloom flowers, and these give you a withering effect. I assume you could use these for some kind of a mob trap if you wanted to, but yeah, just walking into it will give you a wither effect. If this flower is in your inventory, it'll also give you a wither. It's just wither one. It doesn't last super long, so it probably won't kill you. It's like getting hit by one of those wither skeletons, I guess. It can kill you, but it probably won't. But yeah, that's something to be aware of. They are popping up all over the place, and I don't know if there's a way to stop that from happening. So probably what we'll end up doing is either converting all of our bees to, use stone flowers, so they won't spawn any of these. They'll just want like cobblestone or regular stone around. Or we'll get rid of all the grass and just leave one grass block with one flower that all the bees can fight over. Either way, we'll figure something like that out when we set this thing up permanently. You can see I do have a lot of these cocoa beans planted on our jungle wood sign here. We don't have a cocoa bean farm, and I saw that I had a lot of jungle wood here, so I figured, let's go ahead and plant a bunch of cocoa beans. We're gonna need these to make chocolate frames. Cool, so let's start actually getting into some of this stuff. I made up a few of what are they called? The treated frames? Is that what it's called? I made a lot of these things. Impregnated frames, that's what it is. Yeah, we take the wood logs, we put them in the carpenter with the seed oil, and you get the impregnated sticks, and then 8 of those around a string gives you an impregnated frame, and then you take one of these with some cocoa beans. I think it's just 4 beans per frame, something like that. Yeah, and that'll give you a chocolate frame. Now, what this does is increases the production of the bee, but it shortens their lifespan. So you can use those to kill the bees off pretty quickly, like if you just want to get a whole bunch of drones. So we'll probably be using these for that purpose. Let's just make as many as we can. Okay, that should be enough. So another thing we can do, there's soul frames in here, and these things, they do not speed up the bee. They don't shorten their life, but they make it more likely that it will mutate. So something like this is what you want when you're trying to crossbreed, especially earlier on when you're in the regular apiaries. So we are going to make some of these. So soul sand plus those impregnated frames. I really don't know how many of these we need. I'll make that many. Cool. So this will help us along trying to get these bees to do their crossbreeding. Okay. So back at the sign, this very first stage is done. This happened on its own. We have a whole bunch of common bees. Wait a second. Weren't one of these common? Or no? Maybe it was common and they changed again on me. Because I know we had common bees in here somewhere. Oh, you know what? Maybe that's what happened here. Yeah, it made some common drones and it switched over to the noble. Now it's noble for good. Okay. Well, we had the common bee. So I put those up on our sign to show this. So what we need is a cultivated bee, and in order to get that, we have to do the hive bee plus a common. Okay, so that should be a fairly easy breed to do. So we'll just grab, cultivated. So that's a hive bee plus a common. So I actually need, let's put this back. I need like one of these princesses to mix with a common drone that we have over here. In fact, actually, you know what we should be doing? Before we even start doing this, we need to make sure that the bees that we are going to be breeding are purebred. So we need to make ourselves a bee-alyzer. All right, so there we go. There is our bee-alyzer. Pretty simple thing to make. It just takes like 10 or 15 seconds for it to actually craft. You know, another thing we are going to need is a centrifuge. Yeah, we don't have a centrifuge made. So the centrifuge is how we get the honey drops out of the combs. And we're going to need this for the bee-alyzer. So, okay, we can make that. Cool. I wasn't sure if we had those gears, but apparently we did. So there's a centrifuge. Very easy thing to craft up. So we just need to find a spot to set this thing so it can get some power. Yeah, we're starting to run into an issue where we're running out of space. Maybe I'll just set it right there for now. This is not good. I really didn't want to be at the point where I'm having to put machines on the floor, and that's where we're at now. Maybe we'll end up moving these machines back or make a second row up there. I don't know. We'll figure something out. Okay, so anyway, we need some combs. Let us just grab some of these regular honeycombs. I've gotten these from the hives when I've broken those apart. So these go into the centrifuge. They take just a few seconds to happen. And I believe each one of these should give us a honey drop and a beeswax. All right, well, this thing finished up and we did not get a honey drop and a beeswax for every single one of those combs. It looks like we didn't get 4 honey for some reason. Anyway, so there's our honey drops. We can take those into our beelizer and we put them right here in the upper right hand corner. Awesome. And then we just drop our bees right here. This will reveal all their hidden stats and we can see those in these little slots. So let us go over here and check out, I don't know, that common drone, for instance. I'm sure it's half common and half something else. Yeah, let's pick this up and see what we got here. So this bee right here is, it's half common, half meadows. So it has a chance of becoming a meadows bee when we breed this with something else, and we don't want that. So we want probably to make purebred common drones, so we might have to start all the way over from the very beginning. But yeah, this shows us all the different stats of it, how long it lives, how fast it makes combs, how fast it'll pollinate trees, what types of flowers it likes. These like flowers, obviously. The rocky or the stone bees like stone. The fertility, this will give us 2 offspring every time the queen bee dies off. We'll get 2 drones. All right, so it's territory. That's just the default, and it doesn't have any special effects on it. Likes daytime. It does not like nighttime. It does not fly in the rain, and it does not fly when it can't see the sun above the hive. Okay, so the rest of the stats, look at this stuff. It goes like all the way off the screen down here. That's weird. I wonder if that is, I wonder if that's normal. I don't know. I really don't know. I guess it doesn't really matter. All right, so what we need to do, let's start over from the very beginning. Yeah, we were able to get the common bees, and those common turn into the nobles on their own. So I guess they got cultivated in there somehow. we're going to start all the way over from the very beginning and make ourselves a purebred common bee. So the very really? Is that because I was on the chest on this thing? That's weird. Well, I guess it does extra tick damage if you're standing on it. I didn't know that. So let me go ahead and get rid of this stupid flower. These things are annoying. I don't know if there's a way to turn that off or whatever. Like I said, we can figure out a way to make it so no extra flowers will spawn around here, but it's just a lot of work to do. All right. So probably the first thing I want to do, let's just turn off our servo here. So when the bees die off, nothing else happens. We'll just get some drones and the princess over here and maybe a comb. All right, so here we go. We have the forest princess and 2 drones, and these should all stack. I do believe, yes, they do, because they are all the same style of bee. So we'll put those all in here. In fact, we'll put this one in here too. We are going to use this forest princess. We need to mate that with a purebred meadows or any other type of hive bee. I think we'll do meadows. Yeah, we got a lot of meadows over here. All right, so we will do that. Put the meadows in here with the forest. That should make a common bee, and we'll throw some soul frames in here just to help make sure that that happens. So the next thing we gotta do is just wait for its health bar to go all the way down, which is gonna take a minute. So we might move on to something else while we wait. Well, that happened pretty fast. I'm noticing that we did get common drones and a forest princess. So this is probably half forest, half common, maybe, or half meadows. I don't know. But yeah, the common drones, these do stack. So these should be purebred. I was checking this out. I wasn't really sure how the soul frames worked. It's been a long time since I've used these things, and it made the health bar jump down a huge amount every single tick. I said we might go do something else, but then I saw how fast this was going. I was like, no, we'll just wait. But anyway, let's take a look at these bees and just verify these are, in fact, purebred common bees. Stick those right in here. Yeah, common, as I thought. This one is the common meadows hybrid. And let's take a look at the princess real quick. And this is, forest common. So we could convert this over to a common just by sticking this bee back in here. I don't want the soul frames because I don't want it to mutate. We'll stick that in here with these 2 common bees with the chocolate frames, which will make this thing die off faster. But yeah, since it's got a bunch of common bees that it's going to be mating with, it's highly likely that this thing will switch over to a common princess. And once we have that, we can mass produce the common drones, and that's what we want to do. So that is the next step in this process. All right, guys, so I've been letting these bees do their thing. We've gotten up to 8 common drones. I'm going to let this go overnight, collect a whole lot of these things. So in case we need a common princess for some reason and it turns into something else, we can use these drones to convert that common or whatever the princess turned into back into a common princess. So anyway, we need a large stockpile of these drones, and that just takes a bit of time. So what we're going to do, we'll leave the bees alone. We'll probably just do like updates or things like that going forward. But yeah, it just takes a lot of time. And we've already spent a bunch of time in this episode messing with bees. So let's move on to something else. I think what I'd like to do, you know what? Let's go to the Twilight Forest. There's some progression in here that I've been meaning to do. We're only here the one time, right? Well, maybe we visited for the quarry a second time. What is that? You are a Bazals, and you are dead. So anyway, yeah, there's a progression through here, and I don't remember what the progression is. Let us look at, what do we have to do? The achievements? I think it's the achievements. So we go here, we can click through this. Twilight Forest, okay. So where are we, and what have we done? Yeah, we need to do the Naga. Okay, so we need to go find ourselves a Naga. I don't think I found one of those bosses yet here. We've collected some of these things. Yeah, okay. So anyway, first thing we need to do, we need to find ourselves a Naga. Let's take a look at the map. I don't think I found a Naga yet. In fact, we haven't really done much exploring here in the Twilight, have we? Okay. So what I need to do is go around, fly around until we find one of those. It's like a little square thing that has the Naga in the center. Let's go do that real quick and see if we can take on the Naga. Maybe we'll be able to one-shot it with our crazy crossbow. I'm not sure, you know, how much damage that's going to take. But yeah, let's go ahead and give that a try. Well, I didn't find a Naga. In fact, I found a... This is obviously the largest sized hollow hell. I found one of these. See right through you. Pretty quickly. Let's actually head up and take a look at what this thing looks like from the outside so you guys can get an idea. Yeah, the hollow hill that we found before, that was not the largest size. I think that was the medium size. This is the largest size one, and it has those, whatever those were, haunts, guests, I don't know, something like that, those ghosts. Yeah, it looks pretty big from the outside, and that is, in fact, the biggest one, and I do believe that's the only one that spawns those mobs in it. So anyway, yeah, that's pretty cool. I was trying to find one of these previously in like a different series and I was unable to. Yeah, that's really awesome. So I'll mark this down so we can capture those things. I do believe those drop glowstone. Yeah, they drop a decent amount of glowstone, so that could be something that we'll use as a spawner later on. Cool. Alright, well that didn't take long. I found a hedge maze. This isn't exactly what we're looking for, but these things can have some pretty cool items in there, and there's a lot of spawners here too. I don't think there's any useful monsters that spawn from these spawners though. Alright, so nothing really good in there. These hedge blocks can be used for killing monsters. Like, they do damage to you if you're standing on them. Same thing for the monsters. I think it only does damage if you're on top of them. Like, spiders can climb up the side, and I do not think they take damage. Anyway... Yeah, we got a diamond in there. That'd be pretty cool if we needed diamonds. Just kind of looking at these chests real quick. Obviously, with a jetpack, that makes this stupidly easy. Like, if you had to walk through this whole thing and deal with the spiders, it'd be a little harder. Alright, so pumpkins. Yeah, I don't think there's anything of too much value that spawns in these hedge mazes. Did we look at this one yet? I don't know if we did. No, we didn't. And there's nothing really in there. Okay, but anyway, I was looking on the map, and yeah, as I came to this, the map expanded out and showed this over here. So we do, in fact, have a Naga spawner. Am I facing the right way? This way. All right. Oop. Tree, get out of my way! All right, so here we go. Here is the Naga area. This is the first boss that we'll have to deal with. Pink sheep. Looks like there are the rubber trees in the center, but if you can see, like, below this rubber tree, there is a spawner right there, and that thing will turn into the boss as we get closer. I don't know if there's any way to actually get that without spawning the boss. I don't think there is. But anyway, I'm curious to see if we can one-shot it with this thing. We're pretty close on the wither, and I'm not sure if this thing has much or as much health as a wither. That's kind of weird. Is this thing stuck? What's it doing? Is it dying? Is it killing itself in the tree? Is it really killing itself? Oh, that's too funny. Look at that. It spawned with its head in the tree. I guess they can't move or whatever. Can I make it faster? There we go. Well, I was able to kill it from half health. That's pretty awesome. Well, now I want to find another one and do this legitly. Oh, man. Well, we got a Naga trophy, so that's kind of cool. We got the epic shader grab bag from Immersive Engineering and a yellow heart. I think this will make our 10th one. So at this point, we should be able to get another full heart, another full thing of the yellow heart canisters, and we'll have 30 health. That'd be pretty sweet to do. Let's take a look at the map one more time. Now I kind of want to fly around and find another one of these and see if we can one-shot it, because that was kind of cheap that it killed itself, basically. All right, well, let me go do that real quick. These shouldn't be too hard to find. Yeah, I'll go see if I can find another one real quick, and we'll see if we can one-shot it. All right, guys, well, I came across yet another one. It's got a bunch of these Thaumcraft Greatwood trees in here, and looks like this one is a spider web tree, so we'll get a little bit of extra loot out of this thing. So the spawner is right there. Yep, let's go see if we can one-shot the Naga. All right, guy, come here. If I can hit him. Nope. Yeah, a little bit laggy. There we go. Yep, one shot. Awesome. Cool. All right, so let's go check out the cobweb tree over here and see if we can get any good loots out of it. The spawner's off to the side, which is kind of interesting. It's like the tree shifted over one, huh? Unless there's more than one spawner and chest here, which I don't think so. Nah, the tree just shifted over one for some reason. Okay, so we got the Division Sigil, just some stuff. Unknown Dimlets, cool. Yeah, we got two Naga trophies. These things. Whoa. Crazy deer. Yeah, those things you can just place on the wall. They look like a player skull or whatever, so that's awesome. All right, so let's take a look. Achievements. Go back to Twilight Forest. All right, so Naga's done. So we got the Shimmering Scale. Yeah, we got this. So the next thing we have to do is go find a lich. Now, I did discover at least one lich tower. Yeah, there's one here. And I just flew past another one over here. It's one of those cloud biomes. Let's see. Yeah, there's another one here. Yeah, they're not that uncommon. You can find them pretty well anywhere. So let's go to a lich tower. Is it this way? It might be this way. Yep, it's this way. All right, so the Lich Tower should be right here. Okay, we'll let things render in real quick. This actually looks like a rather small one. Huh. All right, well, anyway, let me get my axe. Not that one. We'll use this one. All right, so what we got in here? Oh, Twilight Lich. There it is. Okay, so this guy is a little different. He shoots out these flame balls or whatever, and you have to shoot them back at the Lich and then destroy his shields. There we go. Yeah, sometimes it's a little laggy. It takes a bit of practice and some luck to actually hit his shields down. There we go. So his shields are down, now he spawns these zombies, and we can just kill him with our sword pretty quickly. There we go. Alright, well now we got the crazy magnet action happening. Let me pull some of these blocks out of my inventory here. Well, that's not quite enough, is it? Alright, well, hold on just a second. Let's send some stuff back. We don't need this in our inventory. All right, there we go. All the sounds went away. Yeah, the Naga scales that we got. We don't need this or that. All right, so there's our Lich trophy. We got a Scepter of Life Draining. 99 charges left. That's pretty cool. And, ooh, we got a lot of armor with a bunch of protection on it. Soulbound, awesome. Well, that's, you know, if nothing else, we can get the Soulbound off of there and use that for something more important than gold pants. Cool, cool. I like it. All right. Well, there's nothing really much else of note. We did get another yellow heart, as we will with every single boss kill. So, I think you can find treasure in these things, but there's like not a lot of good stuff here. This apparently just has a lot of cactus for some reason. I'm not sure why. Skeleton with the flying pig. So many monsters around. We got a library so we can get some books and stuff if we need to. What else is in here? Anything? Oh, there's a book shooting at me. I was like, what is making that sound? Maybe we'll put a torch in here so we can kind of see what's going on a little bit better. Ah, there's a zombie spawner. All right, get out of here, zombie spawner. All right, guys. Okay, the magnet is just getting out of control. Too many things in my inventory. All right, cool. Well, there's not really a whole lot of stuff here. The Twilight Forest is kind of designed for addition to vanilla Minecraft. When you add it into a mod pack like this and you have a lot of overpowered armor and weapons and things, yeah, you can kind of blow through it pretty easily. But I have gone through this thing as legitly as possible in a previous playthrough. I think it was in the Monster series. Yeah, anyway, it's pretty fun doing this without, you know, being super overpowered. But at the same time, you know, once you've done it once, you've seen it. So let's go ahead. Kind of a spawner, that's a skeleton spawner. All right. You know, I think we'll just leave all this stuff alone. We'll get out of here and we will look at what's next. Well, it looks like the next boss in the Twilight Forest is going through the maze, and that takes a little bit of time, and we're running short on time for this episode. So I'm going to try and pull the soul bound off of these pants, and we'll probably apply it to either our pants or our boots. We might do it to the solar helmet, but I think eventually we're going to upgrade this to the highest tier solar helmet. So I don't know. Speaking about soul bound, over at our mob farm, I was voiding all of the different, well, I guess trash canning, all of the different armor pieces, but I have since added a new pipe. So there's a vacuum hopper like right there, and it pulls the items that drop from the mobs and sends it into an item duct. So the item duct goes over here and has a vacuum item duct. So items try and go this way first. And then they try and go into these filing cabinets, and then there is a trash can at the end with a filter, so only certain items will get trashed. Everything else goes straight down into our ender chest, so like all the mob drops and things like that. So this has been collecting a decent amount of stuff. Yeah, we got some gold armor here, we got pants, golden pants, golden chest plate. Oh, check this out, we got another soulbound item here, so that's awesome. Oh, two of them. Nice. So we can get soulbound off of those as well. Might have to repair them first. We have the leather armor up top. I'm not sure how much of this we have. Okay, and no more soulbound there. Then we got the chain armor on the bottom. I'm still waiting for a pair of chain boots to come through so I can put it in a filing cabinet and then, you know, set that on the pipe. Did we get any chain boots yet, maybe? No. Oh, we got Joe Hill's head finally and Topmass's head. Cool. Anyway, guys, yeah, I think that's gonna do it for this episode of Feed the Beast Infinity Evolved Expert Mode. Hope you guys like this episode. Yeah, we're messing with bees a little bit. Gotta get going on that. That's for sure. Been spending time preparing for it, so gotta make it happen. And yeah, then we took some time in the twilight, knocked out a few bosses, gained that progression out of the way. Pretty cool. All right, guys, that's it for today. Thank you guys for watching. Remember to leave a like on this episode if you did like it, and we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye-bye.